Turkey has invaded Syria with the goal of beating back U.S. allied Kurdish militias. RT correspondent Anya Parenpil is with us tonight for the breakdown of this. It seems like President Erdogan is pretty determined on this.
Absolutely, Ed. The latest front to open in this conflict highlights just how many foreign actors are involved in what some have referred to as a Syrian civil war. At least 9 people, including 6 civilians, were killed as a result of Turkish airstrikes conducted on Saturday. According to Turkey's prime minister, the assault dubbed Operation Olive Branch consists of Turkish troops, warplanes, artillery, and tanks offering support to Syrian rebels for hire, known as the Free Syrian Army. The FSA was previously backed by the United States with the goal of ousting the Assad government, but now find themselves employed by Turkey to fight another U.S.-backed militia, the Syrian Democratic Forces, or SDF. Turkish forces reportedly captured several villages in the Syrian region of Afrin over the weekend. Their goal is to oust Kurdish forces known as the YPG, or People's Protection Units, because it's seen as an extension of the Kurdistan Workers' Party, or PKK, which Turkey considers to be a terrorist organization. While President Donald Trump ended U.S. support for so-called moderate rebels early on in his presidency, including the Free Syrian Army, he continues U.S. support for the Kurds. That's despite November reports, according to Turkey's foreign minister, that Trump promised Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan he was ending that policy. Russia's foreign ministry blamed Trump's support for the Kurds for the current situation, saying, quote, uncontrolled deliveries of modern weapons, including reportedly the deliveries of the man-portable air defense systems by the Pentagon to pro-U.S. forces in northern Syria, have contributed to the rapid escalation of tensions in the region and resulted in the launch of a special operation by the Turkish troops. Speaking Monday, Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov charged the United States with inflaming separatist aspirations among Syria's Kurds, stating Washington has actively encouraged and continues to encourage separatist sentiments among Kurds, which he said, quote, is either a lack of understanding of the situation or an absolutely conscious provocation. He also accused Washington of discouraging the Kurds from engaging in dialogue with the Syrian government. Turkey's actions come just several days after Secretary of State Rex Tillerson said the U.S. will maintain an open-ended presence in Syria. His comments followed an announcement from the Pentagon that it was creating a 30,000-strong militia described as a border force in Syria. Tillerson later scrambled to walk back that announcement, saying the policy had been, quote, misportrayed after Erdogan promised to strangle such a border force, quote, before it's even born.
The U.S. is in the process of creating a terror army on our border. What we have to do is nip this terror army in the bud. America, do not encroach on our borders. Do not provoke us, or we will run out of patience.
It appears now Tillerson's remarks were not enough to keep Ankara from going to war. Back to you, Ed.
Thanks, Anya.